book in Amoretti is a love story. It's all about love, it's all about passion and desires. But it's about, you know, about the love which has been silenced across the ages, across countries and civilizations. We felt that we should, you know, create a voice for all those love stories, all those people who couldn't express their love. So it's not exactly only about LGBT or what we know about them. It's much more than that. It's about all form of love, I mean, which has been taboo, which has been suppressed. Coincidence was that she happened to be also, you know, a very active worker, a very active, you know, person in the entire LGBT movement. So that, you know, just, you know, like made fantastic connection. And after hearing the draft and also after hearing the story, I wanted, she was immediately hooked into it. I mean, she was really excited because it was aligned exactly with the movement she was involved in and the things she believed in. So we started reworking on the entire book, and what happened eventually is that, being a woman, she brought, you know, a lot more angles to all the women characters. This book is all about, you know, a number of very strong women, women characters, and she brought in a lot of nuances, a lot of you know, subtle things which, you know, being a man, I had ignored. So I think, I mean, not only the academic side which I was looking at, but I believe she brought in a lot more than that, a lot more subtleties, a lot more nuances, and finally the name Broken Amoretti was also coined by her. The Broken Amoretti is my third book. It's really the last two books which I have written were thrillers. Thrillers based on ancient Indian history. And while I was doing the researches for the last two books, I mean, I came across a lot of, you know, narratives from the Indian and the Greek mythologies, and also a lot of narratives about, you know, ancient Indian history and also Greek history, right? And one thing I figured out that across ages, across cultures, I mean, there have been certain types of love stories, I mean, certain types of relationships which haven't got proper voice. So that's about the book, you know, the Broken Amoretti, which is a sort of voice for all the love stories, for all the relationships which have been silenced since ages. And especially with this, you know, discussion about Section 377 and all the activism that we have seen, I think it's the right time for people to talk more about it and give voice to, you know, all those relationships which we, the society, has, you know, relegated to as being unnatural, unconventional, or, you know, abnormal, but in reality they are as normal, as natural as anything else. So I think I felt, you know, like inspired to, you know, talk about that, and that's about it. It's a very intense love story, right? It's actually like, it's a number of love stories, right? And the common theme is that most of the love stories has something apparently unnatural where they are not at all unnatural, they're as normal as possible. I mean, I spent, you know, four years of my life in IIT Kharagpur, and I think that was one of the most creative like period in my life. I started spending more and more time on music. I started, you know, writing short stories, and I think more than that, I mean, more than the creativity, I believe it just, you know, it was a big exposure for me. Like, it was a small India, you know, and having grown up in West Bengal and in Calcutta before that, it was like I was exposed to a miniature India in 4 years, right? And it brought in some, I think, like universality within me. I mean, which can thrive only when the atmosphere is very cosmopolitan, very liberal.